So here we have two caterpillars, and they're not just any caterpillars. This is Belinda, and this is Curtis. And Curtis loves being a caterpillar. He reckons there's nothing better in the whole world than being a caterpillar. Do you know why? Because he gets to walk along branches, and he loves to walk along branches. He walks along branches forward. There he goes there, walking along. And sometimes he even walks backwards. He likes that as well. So the two things he loves to do are walking forward on branches and also walking backwards. But not only that, sometimes he likes to stand up. Now, if you've ever seen caterpillars, they can do this. They can summon all that power they've got and they can stand up. And he likes to eat leaves. So he thinks to himself, there's nothing better than being a caterpillar. I walk forwards, I walk backwards, I eat leaves. Nothing could be better. Now, Belinda looks at him and says, well, Curtis, you know, I think there might be some better stuff. That might not be all that life is all about. And he can't even get his head around that. He doesn't even want to hear what she has to say because he's so convinced that there's nothing better. And one day, as he's walking along the branch, he notices this big leaf. It's the biggest leaf he's ever seen. It's big and fat and juicy, and he thinks this is going to be tasty. And Belinda says to him, Curtis, stop. Don't eat that. Why not? He says. Because it's not a leaf. He says, well, it looks like a leaf. And Belinda says, it's not a leaf. It's actually a chrysalis, a pupa. He says, what's that? He says, well, when a caterpillar comes to the end of their life, they go into this thing called a pupa and they build it around themselves, and that's where they kind of finish their life. And that's it. That is what's happened there. He says, you mean there's a caterpillar in there? He says, like a kind of caterpillar coffin. He says, yes, that's right. That's what it is. He says, that is gross. He says, ugh, I'm never doing that. I'm never going to build one of those. And he absolutely refuses to do it. Well, his life carries on for a while. And after a few more months, eventually, because he never builds one of these things, he one day falls off the branch. And that's the end of him. Meanwhile, oh, it's not real. It's not real. Okay. Now, meanwhile, Belinda comes to the end of her caterpillar life and she makes herself into a pupa. And after a while, something very special happens. Her life as a caterpillar comes to an end. She dies as a caterpillar. But that's not the end of the story, because not long after that, she changes. She changes into something. I'm hearing the ooze before I've even done it. She changes into something quite amazing. What does she change into? She changes into a beautiful butterfly. And there she is. And now she doesn't just have to crawl along. She doesn't just have to crawl along the branches. She gets to fly wherever she wants to go. Anywhere she wants to go, she gets to fly. And she thinks to herself, now I know what being a butterfly is like. That is so much better than being a caterpillar. And poor Curtis never got to that point where he understood. Why am I telling you this today? Because we have to change in our lives. You know, part of us has to die before we receive something better. And the Bible says that, first of all, we have to die to a life of sin before we get born again anew to Christ, so that we can be part of his family. And what Easter teaches us is our body has to die so that we can fully become what God meant us to be, that we can live with him forever in heaven. And it's not something we should be scared of. Now, let me tell you this, we're not turning into butterflies, but we're going to turn into something even better. We're going to be with God forever. And when we're in heaven with God, millions of years later, we'll look back and think, why were we so bothered about what we did on this earth when being in heaven is so much better? I love Easter. Just as Corey said, just as Ernie said, it's a fantastic day because it reminds us that because of what Jesus Christ did, if we take hold of that, if we put our faith in Jesus, and not only the death of it, that he died on the cross, but the fact he was raised again, he gives us that promise that we too will be born again, will rise again, so that we might be with him in heaven forever.